Good morning, boys and girls. My name is Derek Denunzio, and I teach fourth grade at Lorraine Elementary School in Exeter Township School District. Today, I'm going to be coming to you on behalf of the Teachers in the Parks program, and this lesson is geared towards incoming third and fourth grade students. So I will be reading a book to you today. I'm just going to share my screen here on the National Football League. So first of all, this is a nonfiction book, and it opens with the table of contents. Well, the title, National Football League by David Rausch. Learn more about the National Football League. The table of contents gives you a little bit of an idea of what the book is going to be about. And these, although this is a short story, so it's not necessarily chapters, each of these would be kind of like a chapter in a longer book if you're talking more about a novel. So if you want to know specifically what is the NFL, it's on page 4. If you want to know more about a history of the NFL, it's on page 6. And then that's one type of part of a nonfiction book that can help you. And then if we go to the back, you will see a glossary. A glossary is good for giving you keywords in a book and definitions of those words. And we're actually going to do I'm going to read these to you first so you have a good idea of what some of these words are going to be when I read them. And then you have an index. An index is kind of similar to the table of contents, but it's a little more specific. If you wanted to know specifically about like training camp, for instance, that's talked about on page 17. If you want to know about the Super Bowl, it's on pages 8, 20, and 21. Basically, anywhere that any of these are mentioned, it lists the page number for it. And then these are just some other books in the series. Let me go to the glossary. I'm going to read these words to you. So a bye week is a week in which sports teams do not play. A conference is a group of sports teams within a league. Teams in a conference often play one another. Divisions are groups of sports teams within a conference. Teams in a division often play one another. Founded means created or formed. Free agents are professional athletes who are free to play for any team. Free agents do not have contracts, so they're kind of playing in independent leagues and things like that, hopefully trying to get an NFL team to pick them up for an offer of a contract. A league is a group of people or teams united by a common interest or activity. The NFL draft is a yearly event in which NFL teams pick college players to play for them. Officials are people who enforce the rules during a game. Professional athletes are athletes who get paid to play a sport. Quarters are the four periods of time in a football or a basketball game. Rookies are professional athletes in their first year of playing. Special teams are a group of players used during kickoffs, punts, and other special plays. Wild cards are teams that make the playoffs without winning the division. So we go back to the beginning. See the table of contents again. So what is the NFL? The National Football League is the most popular American football league. Its players are some of the best professional athletes in the world. History of the NFL. In 1920, four teams from Ohio held a meeting. They founded the American Professional Football Conference. This became the NFL in 1922. The first president. Sports star Jim Thorpe was the first president of the league. He was known as the greatest athlete in the world. Another league formed in 1959. It was called the American Football League. The AFL and NFL joined together in 1970. The first Super Bowl. In 1967, the best NFL and AFL teams played each other. The game was the first Super Bowl. A look back. So here's a little bit of a timeline of the NFL. August 20th, 1920, four football teams from Ohio form a league. They call it the American Professional Football Conference. September 17th, 1920, more teams join the league. The name changes to the American Professional Football Association. June 24th, 1922, the name changes again. It is now called the National Football League. 1934, the NFL changes the shape of its football. The ball becomes longer and skinnier. February 8th, 1936, teams pick college players in the first NFL draft. Jay Berwanger is the first player ever drafted. October 22nd, 1939, an NFL game is on television for the first time. August 14th, 1959, the American Football League is created. This league joins the NFL in 1970. September 7th, 1963, the Pro Football Hall of Fame opens in Canton, Ohio. And January 15th, 1967, the Green Bay Packers beat the Kansas City Chiefs for the first Super Bowl. The teams. Today, the NFL has 32 teams. They are separated into the American Football Conference and the National Football Conference. Both conferences have four divisions of four teams. So here you see the AFC and the NFC. We are close to Philadelphia here, so probably a lot of Philadelphia Eagles fans. They play in the NFC East, as you see here. And then the Pittsburgh Steelers, the other Pennsylvania team, plays in the AFC North. My favorite football team, they are not very good, they stink. But my favorite football team is the Miami Dolphins, and they play in the AFC East. Each team has 53 players. They play offense, defense, or special teams. Teams pick rookies from the NFL draft. They also trade players and add free agents. Playing the game. Every NFL game starts with a coin toss. Then four 15-minute quarters follow. Both teams try to score touchdowns and field goals. Officials throw flags when the rules are broken. And there's an example of an official throwing a flag. Tie game. A tie game goes into overtime. This lasts for 15 minutes. The extra period can end with a tie. That usually doesn't happen in football, but occasionally it does. And if there are more than one penalty on a certain play and the official has already thrown his flag, I've actually seen the official take his hat off and throw it too, which always makes me laugh. That's basically another – he doesn't have another flag to throw, so he takes off his hat and he throws that down. And then you know things are getting a little out of control when they have to throw their hat on the turf. Football talk. Extra point. When the offense kicks the football through the goalposts after a touchdown, that's worth 1 point. A field goal is when the offense kicks the football through the goalpost, and that's 3 points. It's not after a touchdown. First down, when the offense gains 10 yards, results in four more plays. A fumble is when a player loses a hold of the football. An interception is when the defense catches a pass thrown by the offense. A safety is when the offense is tackled in their own end zone. The defense scores 2 points. And it doesn't say it here, but they also get the ball after a safety as well. Touchdown, when a player carries or catches the football in their opponent's end zone, that's 6 points. And 2-point conversion is when the offense carries or catches the football in their opponent's end zone after scoring a touchdown, that's worth 2 points. The regular season. NFL players go to training camp in July. Next, they play four preseason games. Then the regular season begins. Each team plays 16 games and has one bye week. The playoffs and the Super Bowl. The best team in each division makes the playoffs. Four other teams advance as wild cards. Teams battle until each conference crowns a champion. The NFC and AFC champions play each other in the Super Bowl. The winning team raises the Lombardi Trophy in victory. They will be remembered forever. Tuned in. The Super Bowl is often the most watched television event of the year, and just one tiny 30-second Super Bowl commercial often costs millions and millions and millions of dollars to air during the Super Bowl. And that's because the people that are selling products or whatever they're actually selling, a service or a product, a lot of times you'll see like Doritos or Pepsi or something like that, a large company, they know that millions and millions and millions of people are watching, and they're probably going to get a lot of business from it. Sometimes the commercials, to be honest, are a little more exciting than the game. All right, so that's the end of the book. It was a roughly, it was a pretty short book. So I actually had a backup book here that I'm going to read to you. It's also about football, and it's entitled Incredible Football Records by Matt Scheif. Learn more about the amazing feats and outstanding achievements of NFL stars, both past and present. Same thing, table of contents like we had before. Record-setting games. Most points in a game, 73 points. Chicago Bears, December 8th, 1940. 73 points. It's the most ever scored by one team in a National Football League game. The Chicago Bears did it in the 1940 championship game. Chicago's Bill Osmanski got the ball in the first minute. He raced 68 yards for a touchdown. The route was on. Chicago scored 11 touchdowns. Wow. 10 different players reached the end zone. Final score, Chicago 73, Washington 0. And I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that Washington was not very good back in 1940 to get beat 73-0. That's pretty bad. Longest game. It involves my favorite team. 82 minutes, 40 seconds. Kansas City Chiefs versus the Miami Dolphins, December 25th, 1971. The 1971 playoff game between the Chiefs and Dolphins was one for the ages. Kansas City kicker Jan Stenerud, I believe, had a chance to win it late, but he missed a field goal. That sent the game into overtime. They played 15 more minutes, still no winner. Finally, Miami scored halfway through the second overtime. Dolphins kicker Yeprimian ended it with a field goal. At 82 minutes, it's the longest game in NFL history. So the Dolphins won. Yay. Largest crowd, 105,121 fans. Cowboys Stadium, September 20th, 2009. The Dallas Cowboys moved into a new stadium in 2009. Their fans could not wait to see it. The stadium had 75,000 seats, yet 105,121 people squeezed in it for the first game. That means that more than 30,000 fans watched the game without anywhere to even sit. Biggest comeback, 32 points. Buffalo Bills, January 3rd, 1993. The Buffalo Bills looked dead. They trailed the Houston Oilers, that was my dad's favorite team actually, 35-3 in the second half of their playoff game. Then backup quarterback Frank Reich caught fire. The Bills charged back with 28 points in the third quarter. They even took a 38-35 lead in the fourth quarter. A Houston field goal forced overtime, but then Buffalo kicker Steve Christie booted the game-winning field goal. Greatest comeback in NFL history was complete. Bills 41, Oilers 38. Sorry, Dad, they beat the Oilers. Offensive explosion. The Arizona Cardinals faced the Green Bay Packers in January 2010. Nobody played much defense. The Cardinals won in overtime 51-45. The teams combined for 96 points. That is the most ever in an NFL playoff game. Individual records. Most receiving yards in a game, 336 yards. That was from Flipper Anderson of the Los Angeles Rams, November 26, 1989. Los Angeles Rams receiver Willie Flipper Anderson was already having a big day. Anderson caught 8 passes for 171 yards, but the Rams trailed the New Orleans Saints 17-3. Just 5 minutes remained on the clock. Anderson was just getting started. He caught a 46-yard touchdown pass. Then his 15-yard touchdown catch tied it. In overtime, Anderson capped his day with a leaping 26-yard catch. It set up the game-winning field goal. He finished with 15 catches for 336 yards. Wow, that's a lot of yards in one game from one player catch. Longest field goal. That's incredible. 64 yards. Matt Prater, Denver Broncos, December 8th, 2013. Playing in Denver can be a kicker's dream. The ball really carries in Colorado's thin mountain air. Broncos kicker Matt Prater knew that. He trotted onto the field in a 2013 game against the Tennessee Titans. 3 seconds remained in the first half. The ball was just past midfield. His kick sailed 64 yards. It split the uprights. His kick was 1 yard longer than the old record. That's a long, long way away to kick a field goal. Most rushing yards in a game, 296 yards. That's incredible. Adrian Peterson, Minnesota Vikings, November 4th, 2007. Adrian Peterson's record day started quietly. He had just 43 yards in the first half, but Peterson was unstoppable in the second half. He darted around San Diego Chargers defenders. He bowled right over tacklers. He was just 3 yards shy of the record in the closing minutes. Peterson took one last handoff. He blasted forward for 3 yards right into the NFL record book. Longest play, 109 yards. A tie between Antonio Cromartie for the San Diego Chargers and Cordell Patterson, I believe, the Minnesota Vikings. Adrian Peterson was not the only one to set a record in that 2007 Vikings-Chargers game. Minnesota came up short on a long field goal attempt. San Diego defensive back Antonio Cromartie caught the ball in the back of the end zone. He ran it all the way back for a touchdown. Minnesota's Cordell Patterson matched that mark in 2013. He returned a kickoff 109 yards. It's a record that can never be broken. It can't be broken because at 110 yards, the ball would be out of the field of play. It would actually go out of the end zone. So that record will never be broken. It could be tied again, possibly, but it would never be broken. Most sacks in a game, 7 sacks. Derek Thomas, Kansas City Chiefs, November 11th, 1990. That's incredible because a lot of players don't even get 7 sacks in an entire season. He got 7 in one game. Derek Thomas was a one-man wrecking crew. The Kansas City Chiefs were locked in a battle with the Seattle Seahawks. Time after time, Thomas blasted through the line. He battered Seattle quarterback Dave Craig for a record 7 sacks. Yet it wasn't enough. The game went to overtime. Thomas nearly sacked Craig an 8th time, but Craig escaped and threw the game-winning touchdown pass. So that's pretty amazing. He got sacked 7 times by one player, and the quarterback did, and he actually still won the game in overtime. That's pretty amazing. Most passing yards in a game, 554 yards. Norm Van Brocklin, Los Angeles Rams, September 28th, 1951. In 1951, Norm Van Brocklin was fighting for the Rams' starting quarterback job. Then teammate Bob Waterfield suffered an injury. Van Brocklin was in. He made a count. Van Brocklin piled up a stunning 554 passing yards in a game against the New York Yanks. The record has stood ever since. I don't know if that will ever be broken. That's amazing, too. Carrying the team. On November 28th, 1929, the Chicago Cardinals beat the Chicago Bears 40-6. Fullback Ernie Nevers scored every one of the Cardinals' points. Nevers scored 6 touchdowns. He also kicked 4 extra points. No player has ever scored that more in one game. Team records. Most points in a season, 606 points, Denver Broncos 2013. Quarterback Peyton Manning led an unstoppable Broncos offense in 2013. Manning threw a record 55 touchdown passes. Denver was chasing the New England Patriots record of 589 points. Manning threw a 63-yard touchdown pass to Demaryius Thomas to break the record. Denver finished with 606 points. That's almost 38 points per game. Wow. Fewest points allowed in a 16-game season, 165 points, the Baltimore Ravens in the year 2000. That was the year I remember. Around that time, the Ravens had an unbelievably good defense. With linebacker Ray Lewis leading the charge, the Ravens' defense was smothering in 2000. Opponents could barely move the ball at times. Baltimore allowed just over 10 points per game that season. The Ravens' D was even better in the playoffs. Their opponents scored just 23 points in 4 games, and 7 of those came on a kickoff return. That's one way to win a Super Bowl. Perfect. In the Super Bowl era, only one NFL team has had a perfect season, and that's my favorite team. The 1972 Miami Dolphins won all 17 games they played. That included a Super Bowl victory. Most Super Bowl titles, 6 titles, Pittsburgh Steelers. Mr. Ricketts is the gym teacher at my phys ed teacher at my elementary school, and he's a huge Pittsburgh Steelers fan. So I'll have to share with him that he was in my book that I read about, or his team was. No team has had more Super Bowl success than the Steelers. It started in the 1970s. A crushing defense nicknamed the Steel Curtain led the way. Pittsburgh won 4 Super Bowls from 1974 to 1979. In the 2000s, strong-armed quarterback Ben Roethlisberger led the team to 2 more. Their 6 Super Bowl trophies are the most in the NFL. Longest losing streak, 26 games, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 1976 to 1977. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers had a rough start. The Bucs entered the NFL in 1976. They did not score a point in the first 2 games. Tampa Bay went 0-14 in that first season. The losing continued in 1977. By December, the streak stood at 26 games. Ouch. Finally, on December 11th, the Bucs came through. They thumped the New Orleans Saints 33-14. The win snapped the longest losing streak in NFL history, winless. The 2008 Detroit Lions went 0-16. They are the only NFL team to go winless over a 16-game schedule. That's probably one of the most embarrassing records that you could ever possibly have in the NFL. Career records. Longest career, 26 seasons, George Blonda. Pro football is a rough sport. Injury and age forced many players from the game early, but not George Blonda. He played a record 26 pro seasons. Blonda's career was unlike any other. He was a star quarterback, but he was also a kicker, a punter, and even a linebacker at times. Blonda was 48 years old when he finally retired after the 1975 season. I can probably say that is a record that will never be broken either nowadays. It's just too competitive and too much of a contact sport. People get hurt too much. Plus, 48 years old, I don't know that many 48-year-olds would be able to keep up with some of the young kids coming out of college nowadays. So that's a pretty impressive record. No offense to anybody out there that's like 48. I'm sure you're in great shape. Most receiving yards, 22,895 yards, Jerry Rice. Most NFL experts call Jerry Rice the greatest receiver in NFL history. Rice entered the league with the San Francisco 49ers in 1985. Over the next 20 years, he rewrote the NFL record books. Rice became the NFL's top pass catcher in every major category. That includes 1,549 catches, 197 receiving touchdowns, and 22,895 receiving yards. I really like Jerry Rice. When I played football when I was younger, I was a wide receiver, and Jerry Rice was always my favorite. And I actually have an autographed football of him in my home office here at my house. Most consecutive starts, 297 games, Brett Favre. Crushing hits, knee-buckling tackles, twisted ankles, football's a rough game. And the quarterback is the center of all the action. That makes Brett Favre's record of 297 straight starts even more amazing. From September 1992 to December 2010, the Iron Man did not miss a single game. He also won three NFL Most Valuable Player trophies along the way. Most coaching victories, yay, my favorite team. 347 victories, Don Shula. Unfortunately, Don Shula just passed away recently. I don't know if it was last year or the year before, but it was pretty recently. Don Shula enjoyed a seven-year career as a player in the NFL, but he made his mark on the sidelines. Shula coached for 33 years with the Baltimore Colts and the Miami Dolphins. He won 347 games while losing just 173 and tying six over that time. He also won two Super Bowls with Miami. 10 straight. Otto Graham was one of a kind. From 1946 to 1955, the Cleveland Browns quarterback led his team to the league championship game every year. The Browns went 7-3 in title games. And then this is the glossary. I'm not going to read through this, but this, again, would be where you could read through all the words and definitions. And this was not in the last book, but this is it's called To Learn More. And it says, in the library. So right here, it shows you different books that you could possibly go to the library and check out if you wanted to learn more about whatever topic. And this is on the web. So you can actually go on, you wouldn't have to leave your house, you can go on the internet and you can go on the web to this website and it will tell you more links about the NFL that you could learn more about it. And then of course we have the index again. The last thing I'd like to share with you today is where I got these books, because any of you out there could also read these books for free. If you go to getepic.com, so it's just getepic.com/promo, you type that in and it will bring you to this page. And if you just click on join free for 30 days for families, then you would probably have to ask your parents for help with this, but you could put your email and password in here to create an account. And then for the next 30 days, you can read over 40,000 books for free. That's pretty awesome. So I have a pretty good classroom library, pretty extensive classroom library in my classroom, but unfortunately none of my kids can read it right now because we're teaching remotely from home virtually. So this is something I'm gonna tell my kids that I'd really like them to get on Epic, and they have a huge 40,000 plus library at their disposal. They don't have to leave their house. They can read them all. If they have their Chromebook or an iPad or even a phone in some cases, you can just read it right there. So pretty awesome. So you all can do that as well. And I encourage you to do that, because the only way you're going to become a better reader is by reading. I say that all the time. Teachers can teach you lots of different strategies, but you will only become a better reader by reading, reading, reading. So important. So I hope you enjoyed my story today. I chose the NFL because I know the NFL season is about to kick off pretty soon. I know the players are starting to do their workouts, and it's kind of the preseason right now. But soon enough, hopefully, fingers crossed, we will have an NFL season this year. And I hope, I hope everybody enjoyed it. Tomorrow is my last day. Tomorrow I'm going to be reading a book on Milton Hershey from the Hershey Chocolate Company. So I hope you enjoy that. And that will air tomorrow at 9 o'clock right here on DC TV. And I hope everybody has a great night, and I hope you stay safe and have a great day. Take care.